electrical donations.
Okay. Bless the I'm kind of tired now. I'd like to go home. Bless the five happy faces and all that stuff.
Not all the faces are happy.
You don't have to tell her that.
Oh, all right.
Come, Dee Dee.
Always a pleasure, Amadeus. I mean, Wilbur.
Yilly.
Sure.
Come on, Willie.
We'll be back. Probably.
Bye, soon. Lady! Bye, Lumpy! And then he flips you the bird. When Dee Dee's not looking, he flips you. He flips just Lumpy the bird.
He doesn't say anything to the kid, but as he turns away, kind of mumbles, "Fuck you."
Dee Dee will cast a summon instrument, and she'll blow like a horn as she's leaving. Yeah, it's like a bugle. It's like a three notes kind of thing.
A bunch of the kids are waving. Yep. A few of the nuns are scowling, especially the cranky one.
Mm-hmm. And then she'll prestidigitate a little like minor illusion of a bunch of like fireworks going off with pixie dust, and then she'll turn invisible.
You hear a dunk dunk dunk, children. You're pretty certain that there's like scripture being read at this point.
Something about frivolity.
Oh, I'm gonna enjoy coming to visit these children.
I'm
thanks
sure
for bringing me
enjoy.
Along, Amadeus. Like, it was a nice night. We can't do it all the time, though, because, you know, we have stuff to do.
No, we cannot, but...
I think the balance is correct.
She just looks up at the orphanage as you guys are leaving. She smiles.
I think between the two of us, we can accomplish a lot of good in this neighborhood.
This neighborhood right here?
South Wall, I mean.
Oh, yeah. Everyone's gonna choose their own path, but, you know, they could be coaxed towards the nice fairy path with the, like, the fairy toadstools and the frolicking and, you know, all that good stuff.
Yes, all that good stuff.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I'm concerned that some of our companions don't share our love of the good stuff.
I know, right?
Why does Slake have to stomp on everything? I don't know. And it's a whole bitch session all the way back. What the fuck is wrong with those psychos?
Slake, so... I think we learned that some souls do better when they're inside metal bodies and they lose their ability to go to sleep and to eat and to drink and laugh and to, you know, do adult stuff between the sheets.
Perhaps, but his loss is no excuse to cause pain to others.
No, but a lot of pain was inflicted to him, and like a wounded animal, he's going to lash out at things. And I did learn a spell, it's called Calm Emotions. I'm going to try that on Slake a few times. Don't tell him that. Next time he's all stomping around trying to break things, he's going to be calm.
Amadeus chuckles.
And as one of her bard spells, she spent it on calm emotions.
Alright.
Yep.
The next army of barbarians we fight is going to be fucking hilarious. Rage! Oh, you want to rage? Oh, now you're all tired and calm. Oh, no.
As for the others, Agony is scared. Who else? Dugan? Yeah, Dugan was really lonely when we first met him. Can't forget that. He's not used to having friends. Capra? Something bad happened to him when he was a kid? Something to do with monsters? That's why he's always obsessed with, like, hunting rats and monsters. Cog? Yeah, Cog's kind of like... Well, he's from a long time ago, so... But he's dealing well.
He still has a bit of that war in him, I think.
Yeah, that new lady. I'm not too sure about her. I think we got another Slake on our hands, Elven style. Gotta watch out for her. Like, free spirit, but really angry. Sunny? Sunny is like a puppy dog. He's like lost. He's like a lost old goat.
He is worrisome in that he's quite intelligent, but at times he's almost childlike.
Yeah.
He still has those powers of a wizard and druid.
He's got no belly button, and for some reason I can't draw his face.
That is a bizarre thing.
Yep. It's like there's some sort of magic that keeps me from making a face that looks like his. Like, you can't draw him. I tried, like, I don't know, 300 times already? I waste a lot of good ink and paints, and I tried different mediums. Media.
Yeah, by the way, take this. He hands you 100 gold pieces.
What's that? No, that's okay.
No. You needn't empty your pockets every time you go there.
No, that's fine. Next time we go, we'll just find more money. We always find money.
No, yes, I give us what I can, but we still need to invest in ourselves at times, so...
Yeah, that's why I'm crafting. Forward. That's why I'm crafting. And save money that way. Frugality!
Just understand that your presence there does more for those children than... Yeah, the money necessarily does.
They're fun, but they're gonna become not fun, like really quick.
To survive in this civilization, they need to learn the rules.
Yeah, hopefully I showed some of them like a different light, like they could go and do what they want. Like the Imperium speak, they should have all the choice in the world. Multiple worlds, even.
Unfortunately, they are poor. That limits one's options.
Really? I'm not rich.
They also have a unique connection to your god, do you not?
Well, 1,000 of one of them.
Most of those children will not have that benefit, nor are they gifted with the powers of a pixie.
Yeah, but this is the way I was born, and that's the way they were born, and they're gonna have to just deal with the, you know, the hand that they were dealt. Make the best of it. That's all yes. That any of us could ever do.
I'm just saying that the best of it for them might not be the best of what you can do.
That's not a fair comparison, Amadeus. They each have a soul.
No question. They have souls.
Yeah. And they're all special. Equally special.
Amadeus kind of just... He was about to say something, then just decided to leave it.
Sure.
Equally. Who are you to judge?
Actually, I have... You might say I've acquired new eyes since I've had my form changed.
You feel her presence like fluttering up and looking at your eyes.
Huh. So to speak.
Oh.
You have dark vision now, don't you?
I do have dark vision, yes.
Your eyes are weird. What happened to you anyways? If you don't mind me asking.
My father was a wealthy man who made enemies. Those enemies did this to me.
You're cursed?
I was experimented on, not unlike Slake was.
What's with all us experimenting on people? We gotta stop that. Like, I mean, that scared really pissed me off.
Yes, well. Having been turned into this thing has given me insight into what I once believed to be true. Revealed that the world is perhaps not as kind and forgiving as I once thought it was.
No. But that's why it's all the more important that we bring brightness to this civilization.
I agree, my little friend. I agree.
It will lose its soul.
Well, we wouldn't want that.
No. No, you're right. There's lots of bad things out there.
Where is everybody? I've been looking around and I found Kong, but nobody else around here.
What do you mean, where is everyone?
Go over to the stairwell.
Okay.
Yeah, everyone's
Mr. Licking the Toy.
Mr. trying to solve the puzzle. It's impossible her to physically make the check needed to solve said puzzle.
Hey, Capra, we played with a bunch of children and we think there's something bad happening to the toys and it's really bad and you know, they have a chance now, but there's this one bad lady and there's something about the harbor. Hi. Hey, what are you doing up here?
The toy doesn't seem to have a red oil in it anymore.
Or did they fucking break it? Fucking Dugan.
Hey, what's this?
Okay, you're basically Mistra is in Agony's study or his working area, amongst a bunch of draconic tomes. There is this cube on the floor. The red sphere is missing. Let's roll perception checks. It's pound perk GC.
Look at that perception check, Amadeus. Yeah.
Can't hide from me.
Amadeus.
And is Dugan's 5 higher, Mark?
It is 5 higher now that he's got that item from.
There are very tiny little things. You can see where that red oil blob seems to have flattened out.
Mm-hmm.
And there's some like little tiny bugs inside.
He looks closer.
Okay. Oh, wait a sec. One of the oil blobs, the oil actually split into 2 blobs. One of the blobs dissipated.
Okay.
There's like a bug stuck in it.
All right.
What you looking at?
Something. The blob looks like it was 2, and then there's a bug or something in there.
Huh. The other one is now like burst, sort of like running along the sides.
It's breaking. What's going on in here?
You can see basically one big bug and one little bug.
And the 2 other ones are way too small to see.
There's things in here.
Ew!
Do they look like bugs or humanoid bugs?
The one is really hard to tell. It looks like a speck, like a speck.
Mm-hmm.
The other one, it's moving. Seems to be picking some stuff up and dragging some things around. It's moving really slowly.
Mm-hmm.
Give me a knowledge arcane.
I don't have that.
Knowledge nature?
I do have that, I believe. Double check.
I think technically he's a nature boy right now.
Humanoid, you mean? Yeah.
He's a humanoid, yeah.
Alright. Plus.
Are you still some content?
No idea.
Sorry?
Arsha Bog.
No, it just people are not socially distancing on our roof right now, which is annoying.
Okay, it might not be a bug, but there's a little tiny, that wasn't in there before. There's a little tiny thing in there.
No, there's new things in here
and
now.
The oil isn't behaving correctly. It was nice. It was a nice like shape before. And now it's just sort of like a mess.
I think they broke it. Yes, it over to
bugs?
Like Dee Dee.
Yeah, what you want me to do with it?
Mm. Dee Dee will look at it with her her alignment detecting.
Okay. This is interesting.
This is not the group to solve this problem, I don't think.
It's broken.
Shaking it. Handy to Slakey. We destroyed it.
Right. Okay. Okay, give me a cast level check.
Just for spell-like abilities? Yeah.
Yep.
12.
Okay, you're not getting an inherent alignment from it. I think it's magic.
Yeah. Where's Sunny?
She's asking Mistra.
Show me where Sunny is.
I head bust the cube.
It's just a stupid cube. Okay. Where's Capra?
Looks at Capra. Like,
where's Amadeus? Sorry, it's Mr. Knows You by Amadeus. All right. Where's Dugganschmirph? Why do you keep on hitting the cube? Where's Sunny?
Okay, where's... let's have another closer look inside.
Where's Slake? And where's Agony? Okay. What the hell, mister?
She's just petting mister. You're a good girl. But
look closer at the cube now, because the cow seems convinced.
Okay. Give me a perception check with a +4.
Timmy says, Timmy's in the well, according to 34.
Mistress is saying Timmy's in the well. That might be Agony. There's a slightly red creature. It's got a tail. It is biped. It's carrying a something.
Ooh.
There's like a thing in the maze.
Well, it looks like they got...
What
that might
there?
Be Agony in there.
What?
Look. Very closely.
It's a red bug.
But look how it moves.
Yeah, but you're jiggling it. It's a red bug. Does Cog have any tools? Like, to make little things big? Like a glass? Let's go see Cog.
We're gonna go over to Cog's workbench.
Okay. He's got one of his magnifying glasses.
Yeah, he's a clockwork specialist.
Probably got the.
Does he have some sort of magnifying glass?
Yes.
Okay. We're not looking through.
Okay. Yeah, that is Agony. Agony seems to be moving extremely slowly. Like extremely slowly.
He's a slow bug.
You can just make out there's Agony, he's carrying something, and then Dugan's fucking impossible. You can see a Dugan. no shit way.
It's like smaller than the pixel kind of thing. He doesn't even register.
Okay, so if Agony's that big. Oh, where's Sunny? Well, you're right, mister. He's in here.
She's now looking around for Sunny.
Agony's carrying something. Could be him.
Huh.
You don't remember Sunny wearing blue, but there's like this red stuff coating. It's like blue and red. Yeah.
Okay.
How do we get them out?
I'm gonna try to detect thoughts on the bug.
Just gonna try to detect thoughts on Agony.
Okay, give me a cash level check.
+6. 25.
Okay. The surface thought, if I might suggest, is how the fuck do I get out of here?
Yeah, sure.
She's gonna be something or whatever. Yeah. Whatever. She's so gonna... this is like 20 seconds after the battle.
Yep.
Time is not moving equally between the two.
Yeah, Agony is basically collecting the party members and trying to wake the druid up. Is effectively the
CPR.
Is Sunny the bird dead? Is his worry, you know.
Oh, is Sunny dead? Yeah. Right? So the thought is Sunny dead?
She's looking at Mr. Can Dee Dee, she's going to try to speak to Agony.
Agony, we're here!
Agony, ain't hearing shit.
Okay, so.
Well, I'm not going to hear.
Does it look like there's a way out? It looks like a maze, right?
It looks like a maze. They're near the end of the maze. So there's all the way to the other end of the maze.
Dee Dee will take out a big scrap of paper and she'll start drawing the maze of the level that they're on, and then where it goes down, she'll start a new maze and kind of like try to figure out how to.
Huh. How do we talk to them? I think I got it.
Which is it?
She's gonna cast light on a tool.
Okay.
And then she's gonna put light around the cube in the direction where they need to go to get out. And she's gonna move the light around based off of which side of the cube she's gonna which direction they need to go, and then the cube she'll put underneath when they need to go down, because I imagine there's down ways.
Yep.
She's gonna help them navigate the maze from the perspective of seeing the maze from the outside. Dee Dee's pretty smart. She's got a 16 in.
Yeah, that's
She could solve the maze.
Yeah, so she's trying to lead them out. I think out down is probably the best way to try to lead them.
So they are moving extraordinarily slowly.
Yep.
This will take a while.
Yep. It's a light spell, so it's not going to like burn them.
No, it's so the within the cube.
Yep.
Just move back into the cube. Them shaking the cube has no impact inside. You don't even.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
It has no impact on gravity. There's no being jostled around. That light spell being mushed up against the side does create a bright spot that is visible.
Okay. So at first we're really like probably
Sunny is encased in this crystal. It's kind of similar to that sepia snake thing. He seems just sort of cocooned. Okay. When you're looking at him up close, it looks like the damage that was being done from the bappening was actually non-lethal.
And the girl?
Capra, do you have a light spell?
Girl is encased in.
Also, okay, yeah.
Why would I have a light spell?
I don't know.
I have a light spell? I got a light spell. Of course I got a light spell.
Okay, Dee Dee's going to go get some green paper. Like, and some red paper.
Red light, green light.
The green is the way they want them to go, and the red is the way we don't want them to go. And we'll move it.
Ooh, that's bad. Ooh, it's good.
Or whatever the equivalent of, you know, like good color, bad color. So she's going to try to lure them with the green light.
Okay.
She is also green skinned and likes the color green and
the nature.
Yep. Yeah.
All right. I think we're going to put pause here.
Yep.
We're trying to find a way. Well, they are moving very, very slowly compared to this time.
It's fine. We need a name for tonight's game.
It Adventures of the Great Werter. Little Orphan Annie.
Oh, fuck, I didn't even realize that. It's Orphan Annie.
Little Orphan Annie. All right.
It would be Anna, actually.
Little Orphan Anna.
Yeah.
That's awesome. Yeah. This cube thing is the big jello cube. If I could do a certain accent, I would, but I can't. So I won't. Right.
With this cat in the boot. Yeah.
All right. Adam was DM. I was player. Mark was player. I will type up the summary of this later on because I think it's beer o'clock for me.
So we got through the downtime encounter.
Yep.
And the first encounter. Yep. We got enough to.
We got enough for tomorrow. Yeah.
Cool. Or for Saturday.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Saturday, well, technically Saturday. Tomorrow in 3 minutes. Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
Your time shenaniganry will not work on me.
Yep.
That was really fun.
Oh, super fun. The stream was commenting how crafty you are as a DM, Adam. Like, there's some craftiness there.
Time to foreshadow the thing, not be like taking up the butt right away.
I'm glad that three of us got in there, Mark, because if there was only one,
oh god,
it would turn into a. Horror movie. You're trying to navigate this maze as this red cube's trying to get you.
As the blob chases you down. Oh,
and Sunny's like, I'll turn into a bird and try to get away. It was good to have, even though it was a creature, it was an E0 AC7 creature. It's good for Agony to beat up something.
To beat the shit out of it. Well, right. When we started flurrying, it's like, it doesn't have that many hit points.
Yep. Just
double the crap out of it.
Yep. We had to figure out to get there, though.
It's the you get grabbed with the 22 CMB check and will save 25 for your paralyzed. It's like, oh!
Mark. There are multiple of these toys out there. If they're nabbing children and ending up in places, there could be more of these things.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
And then it's like, who fucking built the toys and...
We're going to find Cyrus and Edgar. We're going to cause some pain.
They're collecting people.
Yeah.
Well, I guess we do know someone we could go and, question.
Yeah. Well, Cyrus and Edgar obviously have some idea what's going on.
Yeah, when Agony and Sunny and Dugan pop out of the cube of Jell-O and have their stories to tell, we're probably going to be racing back to... Oh, I have a DM point, which I'll spend next time. There is a scene. It's just a world-building kind of scene, but there is a scene that I want to run, which we'll run on Saturday.
Yeah, we got sidetracked.
Yeah, that's fine. No, that's fine. Yeah, good place to leave it. We do need some XP.
Sure. Let's just that ooze was a CR9.
CR9 with three characters. Ow. No wonder it was scary.
The Edgar encounter, you did technically defeat that encounter. We'll give you full XP for that. There was some help, and they weren't quite trying to kill you. Mm-hmm. So that's the CR7. And then investigations at the church is a CR5. So that brings us to 1867.
Okay.
Nice.
Where is that?
Oh, no, sorry. The trap that Sunny got is...
Oh, that's true, yeah.
There'll be a CR5. We'll make it a CR6. A CR6 for dealing with wizard book problems. So 2267.
Okay, that puts us at 61... 1,000 and change, and we need
80.
80,000. Okay. 79 and change.
Yeah.
Cool. Season one is clipping along at a neat pace. Are you here on Saturday, Mark?
Yes, I am.
Awesome. And Amit's here on Saturday?
Yeah, I believe so.
Assuming whatever exploded stops exploding.
Yep. Full house. Cool. All right. Have a good time, guys. I will see you on Saturday for those that are watching on the stream and on YouTube eventually. Thanks for watching. Feel free to hit subscribe on YouTube. And I hope you guys enjoy this as much as we do. TD is awesome. Peace.
Hello.